Running marketing and growing a business is very time consuming, and without the right tools, you will end up spending more time than you should. Today's product review can help you change a lot of your manual processes and automate them, even the processes you didn't think was possible to automate. Today's product showcase is TexAu, and TexAu can help you automate all types of processes, whether it's commenting on tweets, Facebook posts, or maybe even gathering leads for you. All of this is possible with the help of TexAu. So without further ado, let's dive into TexAu and let me show you some cases that you can automate. Signing into TexAu, this is the spices and this is the first view that you see. In here, they have a lot of predefined spices within TexAu, and you can see all of the integrations they have with Craigslist, Facebook, full contact, website, and so much more. The ones that I really like to use is Twitter, which I will also talk a little bit about in the end of this video. But Twitter is something that I'm growing a lot at the moment, and I really like to use TexAu to help me grow my Twitter account. But this is basically a lot of predefined spices in here, where it is that you can scrape trends on Google, you can extract attendees from a LinkedIn event, you can scrape search results from Google on a specific keyword, you can extract Facebook page searches, and so much more, as you can see all the way down here. And it's just loading more and more. If we want, for instance, we want to see a Twitter spice, then in here you can see the different elements that we can do. This one I like to use a lot, Twitter Advanced Search Extractor. For instance, when I want to promote this video right here, I would maybe set up a recipe within TexAu saying that all of the one where I search on TexAu, in this case on Twitter, I want to comment on those tweets saying, hey, I made a review about TexAu, you should check it out here. So this is a great way to automate that outreach process. That's just great. But of course, you can do a lot of different elements in here, but this is just the spices. This is the one that's collecting the data. They're not necessarily doing something about the data, even though it says here that it will like or retweet a tweet, but it's mainly to collect the data, because if we go into the recipes in here, this is full-on recipes that I have set up right now. You can see I have a Twitter follow and unfollow with likes and delays. Then right now I have an untitled recipe, or we can create a new recipe from scratch, where it is that we first select our spice, what it is that we need to extract, and what it is we need to do with the data that that spice extracts. I'll go back to this in a moment. Furthermore, down here, we have a lot of public recipes, and this is full recipes. So this is multiple spices set together. So for instance, here we have one saying, connect with your website visitors using Happier Leads and TexAu. Furthermore, over here we have grow Instagram followers with follow and unfollow likes with delay. This means that it will follow someone and then it will have a delay on some days and then it will unfollow that person and then maybe it will like in between and so on. Again, over here we have grow your Twitter account with follow and unfollow strategy. This is the one that I use and it works very well. I do get a lot of follows back using this strategy and so much more. They are always adding more public recipes. As you can see, it's loading. At the moment, there are not so many recipes, but there are some to get started. And these recipes are a great way to start because they will get you an idea of how you build up a great recipe. Now, moving on to the prospector, this is basically a tool by itself. It is a LinkedIn extractor where you, of course, with your cookie, which I will talk about in a moment, can extract emails from company employees via LinkedIn. And then you can choose whether you want to save it on a sheet or you want to do something specific with them. You can also schedule this spice. Down here in the results, we can see the results from our spices and our recipes. It is divided into two. You can see here I have run this one twice. And of course, it has different results depending on when it is that it's running. If we, for instance, check the one that I was running 29th of June right here, then you can see a lot of different profiles it's been through. I'll show the recipe just in a moment. But here you can see it found a Twitter profile here and it followed it. Furthermore, they have tutorials in here because TexAu can be a quite difficult product to learn how to use. And in here, it is possible to get a lot of different tutorials on how to use it, both the platform, the CRM spice, the spices, the recipes, and so on. If you have a very specific need for a spice and you cannot wait for them to set it up, it is possible for you to make a spice request and for $999 US, they can customize a spice for you exactly what you need. So this is great if you have a custom need or you just can't wait to get that spice and use it. The last two elements down here is their roadmap, which is basically just an iframe from Trello. And then they have the developer app, because TexAu actually allows you to connect with their API through the API key, as you see right here. This is just my API key, but you will also have your own API key if you sign up for TexAu. The last element I want to show you before we dive into the spices and the recipes is the cookie manager. And that is because for each recipe or spice you run on a social media, you need a cookie, because this cookie is used to identify you so that it is the recipe and the spices know that they need to act like you. So all your cookies will be set in here. And do not worry, because you don't need any coding knowledge in order to get your cookies. They have made a Chrome extension which you can use right here. And it is very simple. When you have it on your Chrome, basically you just go to Facebook or to LinkedIn or to Twitter, then you open up this Chrome extension and it will show you the cookie. And all you have to do then is just to copy paste the cookie, of course set it in here, press update cookies, and then you're good to go. Then you can start using the recipes around that social media. Now let's try and go to recipes, and I'll just first show you this recipe that I have here. As you can see, it is very simple, and we have the workflow here where it is that it say that first of all, it will extract Twitter followers, which has something to do with, in this case, Neil Patel. Then it will follow all of these Twitter profiles that it finds relevant. Of course, they need to follow Neil Patel as well. Then it will delay 4 days before it continues to the next step. So this means that imagine it is a tract and a lot of people are put in from the top. And what it will do is that when it is that it has extracted the amount of Twitter followers, it will follow the person and then put it in queue. And then after 4 days, it will like a recent tweet from that person. And then later on, again, after 3 days, it will then like another tweet from that person. And then it will set a delay again on 4 days. And then it will unfollow that Twitter profile. So this is just one example on how you can grow your Twitter profile. One that I would like to use more, which I have used a little bit, but it's not working that well, is let me try and set it up so you can see it. What we'll do, of course, is we'll go back to recipes. We'll then say create a new recipe. Over here, I will take Twitter as my recipe and I'll choose a spice within Twitter. And what I want is that I will extract all the tweets on a specific search. The search URL has been added. I have searched on TexAu and this is my advanced search URL. The category is tweets. I want the tweets. I don't care about the users. And then max count, I will just set to 100 just in case for this specific spice. Now we'll have a bunch of different tweets. We'll have 100 tweets, hopefully. Now we need to do something with those tweets. And what I want to do is that I will maybe start with liking or retweeting this tweet. And then later on, I would like to comment on this specific tweet, which we have down here where we can reply to a tweet using spin tags. But first of all, I would like or retweet. Then of course I need the auth token, which I have within the cookies. It could be nice here if it would just draw it directly from the cookie manager and I didn't have to copy and paste it for each recipe that I make. But that's of course a future improvement. And of course, what is the URL? See, here we need to refer to the URL being up here. So here we gather a lot of tweets and each of these tweets of course has a URL which we need to set in here. So we need to make a type of link between these. After that, I would like to comment on the tweet, but maybe I will put in a delay in this case. So I have added a delay on 2 days and the last thing I want to do then now is that I want to comment on this tweet. And basically, of course, this is that I want to reply to the tweet. Again, I need to add my cookie. What is the tweet link? Again, I need to make a link from here up to the first where it is we gather all of these tweets. And then I need to add my spin tags comments, which will be used to comment on this specific tweet. So this is a great way to grow or to market a specific maybe product, but also a video or an article or an interview. It can be anything. For instance, if you have a SaaS product or you have a website and you have specific categories, let's say you're an agency that sells websites and marketing, well, then you can set up different types of recipes and then you can, for each keyword that you want to search on and you want to be present on, you can make a recipe for each of these and then you can comment on these saying, hey, we're actually doing X about Y, so this is why you need to check out C. Just an example. And it's a great way to really grow and manage your Twitter profile and create a lot of engagement around your Twitter profile. The last thing I want to show you is that TexAu also have a desktop app if you'd like to more work on your computer as is. I'm in the desktop app right now and it looks exactly like you saw in the web. There is no difference at all. I don't know how this is built, but it's working the exact same way, and you can see we have the same animations and it is just a copy paste of how it looked on the web. Of course, it doesn't have some of the elements up here, but it is the same. And this is just another way that you can use TexAu if it is that you want to use it locally on your computer. But overall, that's TexAu's platform and they are adding more recipes and more spices all the time. Taking a look at the pricing structure of TexAu, it is a quite cheap tool compared to what you get. You have to imagine that all of this automation is going to save you hours, hours that you can spend on earning money for your business or something else to grow your business, whereas TexAu is just in the background growing your business as your partner. They do have three different plans that you can choose between, where the cheapest is $29. The difference between the different plans is the execution time, the amount of email enrichments you get, file storage, and concurrent automations. All this taken into account, the endless automation and the more tools and integrations coming month by month, this is definitely worth it in the end. Compared to the competitor Phantom Buster, they are a little bit cheaper than Phantom Buster, and there is a reason for it, which I will discuss just in a moment. But the whole pricing of TexAu compared to what you get is way more than worth it. If you can just save 1 hour per month, you have already earned this tool home again. So I will definitely recommend you that if you're working with growth or marketing at all, take a look at TexAu because it can really help you automate some processes. The support within TexAu started out to be a little bit slow, but I think it was because of the amount of daily users they got when I started testing out TexAu. Because later on, they always respond within an hour or so. So that's just great because working with TexAu, it can be a quite complex product, which is why that maybe often you need to contact the support with questions or ideas you might have. Often I had a certain recipe that I wanted to set up, but I couldn't really figure out how to do it. So I contacted the support and they helped me out to set up this recipe. Now going back to the competitor Phantom Buster. Phantom Buster is a little bit more expensive than TexAu. It is not a lot, but the difference is there. And there is a reason for it because Phantom Buster is a bit ahead of TexAu. Phantom Buster has way more integrations, recipes made, and their overall design is just way more user-friendly when using Phantom Buster. Hopefully TexAu will catch up to this, and that you will also see when I talk about the future just in a moment. But TexAu has some quite interesting things ahead of it. And I think that if they can just keep on adding recipes and integrations and maybe optimize their user interface and with their desktop app, I really think that they will come up and be close to Phantom Buster in the near future. Taking a look at the future of TexAu, they're mainly working at three elements right now. They're working on two integrations to Mailshake and to MooSend. So this is mainly for sending out emails or at least integrating to those email systems. So that's great if you're using those. The other huge element they're working on is the overall app. They're working on making it more stable. They're working on the security and just the overall flow in the app, especially the workflow editor. And this is great to hear because I really feel that it needs to be lifted up a bit, especially if they want to compete with Phantom Buster, who is really number one at the moment. It is really great to see that integrations is a huge focus for TexAu, both in the near future, but also when we look way ahead in their roadmap. They're really focusing on adding a lot of extra integrations. And if you have any needs, any specific needs, you can also write them and they will add it to the roadmap. And then people can vote up your integration if they feel that it's really needed. If we look further ahead, except for the integrations, they are working on, of course, improving their work editor, their workflow, because that's where we spend so much of our time building out recipes in order to automate this. So that's great. Furthermore, they're adding a WordPress integration, a WordPress plugin, which means that you can integrate your website directly to TexAu and you can use the data within there and automate even more processes. It is really great to see this. And taking a look at the roadmap, as you can see right here, there is a lot of great coming up. Using TexAu, I have definitely been able to automate a lot of my processes. For instance, I'm growing my Twitter profile a lot at the moment. Not only the followers, but the engagement and the activity of my Twitter profile is really a high focus for me at the moment. And using TexAu, I've been able to automate the processes around that, because what I do is I find specific tweets that I have something in common with or something that I can interact on. And what I do is then I comment on these tweets, and this entire process I use TexAu for. So that is really great. TexAu is just an overall great product, and I'm really excited for the future. So yeah, that's my review of TexAu, a great automation tool, especially if you're working with growth or marketing. I hope that you liked the video, and if you did, please give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions about TexAu or other products you would like me to review, please leave a comment down below. Thank you so much for watching. Let's catch up on the next one.